هذه الغيبيات التي كنا الجيل الأول بعد غرابة الإسلام بعد غرابة الإسلام بدأ الإسلام غريبا فأثبت القرآن الغيبيات وانقادت العقول واستمر الإيمان في القرون الأولى والثانية والثالثة والجيل المسلمين ما دام المسلمون يبدأون للأطفال بكتاب الله تعالى وتمتزج لحومهم ودماؤهم بكتاب الله تعالى تصديقا وفهما وفهما للغة التي نزل بها ولا يحتاجون إلى كثير عمل بعد القرآن.
So then,
لما زالت غربة الإسلام ابتداء أول بيت الصحابة.
The first generation with the companions after all of these years of the revelation that
بعد غربة الإسلام
in them the belief in Allah سبحانه وتعالى and the matters of the unseen
وتقوت عقولهم على تحمل الوحي.
The strangeness of Islam was removed. That Islam began strange and that strangeness was removed and the people began to like accept wholeheartedly every single revelation that came to them based on their experience and reasoning and knowing it is the truth. Their language. Then the next generation, it became easy to embody these things and to accept these things in the proper manner. And in fact, the Arabic
وانتشرت فصاحة العربي في جميع المسلمين.
The Arabic language itself began to spread, and the understanding of it began to spread amongst the Muslims in the
صار الأئمة التي يدافعون عن اللغة العربية ويدافعون أكثرهم عجما كسيبويه والخليل وكبير صاحب القاموس وغيره.
So then, the in fact,
أكثر أئمة الحديث.
Most of the Imams of Hadith and of even the Arabic language itself were non-Arabs.
من بلاد فارس كسيبويه إمام النحو
such as سيبويه
وصاحب القاموس
the Imam of النحو and
وصاحب القاموس
and the author of القاموس
وغيرهم من أئمة والقراء كلهم السبعة لا يزيد منهم ثلاثة على عرب والآخرون كلهم عجم الذين يحملون القراءات
the scholars of the قراءات of the different recitations of the Quran they were mostly non-Arabs.
وجميع مشاهير الحديث ليس منهم من عرب غير مالك وأحمد بن حنبل.
And all the major imams of hadith.
غير مالك وأحمد بن حنبل. لا يوجد عربي منهم من مشاهير. وأحمد بن حنبل.
Besides Imam Ahmad, the six صحيح books of.
وغيرهم من حفاظ فارس.
Other than them of the حفاظ of Persia, they were all Persian.
أكثر المحدثين من تلك البلاد. كالترمذي والنيسابوري والبخاري ومسلم وغيرهم من حفاظ الحديث.
That all of these scholars that were mentioned of hadith, they were from Persia.
صارت لغة الإسلام ولغة القرآن ولغة الحديث ووصوله كلها في جزيرة الإسلام هي الأصل وهي الفرع ويرجع إليها.
So then the foundation and the understanding of the Arabic language was spread
بأصولها وحديثها وتفسيرها وقراءاتها
with its proper understanding and proper eloquence and proper rules and grammar and
وصار لا يدخل المسلم الإسلام لا من إفريقيا ولا من فارس ولا من الباكستان ولا من الهند لا وتحكمت هذه اللغة وصارت هي أولى لغة له.
And then the norm in all the Islamic lands
كل من دخل في هذا الدين
land that entered into Islam that Arabic would become widespread and become the
هي اللغة الأولى وهي المحترمة وهي الأصل.
It would become the first language and the language of civilization and the language of nobility in that land.
لأن أهم شيء عند المسلم هو دينه وأهم شيء عند المسلم هو دينه.
Because the most important thing for a Muslim is their deen.
فكيف يجهل المسلم أصل دينه؟
So then how could a Muslim be ignorant of the core and the of the religion?
تربى الجيل الإسلامي على هذا إلى القرن التاسع إلى القرن العاشر إلى القرن حتى الحادي عشر الأطفال يحفظون القرآن ويتربون على هذا المنهج السليم.
And this continued to the 9th, 10th, and even the 11th century that the children were raised across the Muslim world on this solid principle.
وتحكمت في عقولهم الشريعة الإسلامية بلغتها.
On this solid foundation and their minds and their frame of thinking and reference was based on this understanding.
وكل ما دخل الطوائف ضال إما عمدا وإما ضلالا خطأ ردوه عنهم بسهولة لتعريفتهم بهذا الدين.
And not that there weren't, you know, any.
كل ما دخل الطائفة.
Every single time there was a misguiding sect or a deviant sect, then what would happen is that they would be rejected by and pushed out by the majority and understood to be misguided and deviant.
لأن الآلات عندهم موجودة، اللغة عندهم وفهم الدين صحيح. ما هو ماذا يقول لهم؟
because the tools for evaluating misguidance were present. They were with the people, they were known. So as soon as they held those false beliefs and there was no, this was without having public schools in like a public school systems.
وتحكم الإسلام وتمكنوا من العلم قرأوا الفلسفة وغيرها إضافية بعد قراءة الإسلام.
So basically the public schools that were available for people to correct.
قراءة الأمور الزائدة على الإسلام كمن الفلسفة والمنطق والأشياء التي ضروري هل لا يقرأها إلا عباقرة تمكنوا من العلم وفازوا ورسخوا ولم يخف على إيمانهم أما عامة المسلمين لا يدخلون هذا المجال.
The public schools were Islamic schools. They were, people were taught their Islamic obligations and so on. Publicly, and this was available for people to learn. And as far as secondary things and dunya matters and even philosophy and so on and all of these things, these were matters that certain people and people wouldn't enter into these matters generally unless they were having a strong foundation in their deen and of a grasp of the Islamic sciences.
هؤلاء قوم من وحالهم أهل يمكن إضلالهم ليس بالسهل إضلالهم ليس بالسهل.
So then a people who this was their state misguiding such a people
ليس بالسهل.
Was not an easy matter.
فلما حكم الله تعالى بإرادته وصدق نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم بأن الإسلام سيعود غريبا جاءتنا المفاسد.
So then once Allah decreed and ruled and
رد الأمر على أولي
as he has warned us through his messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam that Islam will return to being strange, to be viewed as different and strange and odd, then this is what started to happen amongst the
كما يقول العلماء إذا أراد الله أمرا قدم له أسبابا.
Then as the scholars say that if, once Allah decrees a matter, you will see that Allah places causes for it.
وكما وعد صلى الله عليه وسلم بذلك.
As Allah has promised the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam of this matter.
كما وعد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سيقع هذا.
And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has promised us that this matter would.
قال ستتداعى عليكم الأمم كما تتداعى القصعة على الأكلة على قصعتها.
That the different nations will.
الأمم المتحدة الآن هي معنى الأمم.
All the nations and.
ما تقول الأمم المتحدة.
As you say, the United Nations will unite against you. And they will take from you.
As
a group of people, they gather around a plate of food to eat from it. And the companion said, O Messenger of Allah, would this be from our? Will this be because we'll be few in number? The Prophet said, no. But. Rather, it would be like the foam of the sea. What is the foam of the sea?
واحد يقول لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله لكن ما يعرف أين الدليل. يتربى مع أبائه. يتربى مع قومه. وليس له علم. هذا الغزاء كفزان. أي أحد يمكن أن يسلخ من ذلك المنتسب إليه. ويقول واقع لا موجود.
That a person who just says لا إله إلا الله and never learned, is never taught why they believe what they believe, or where their belief
comes from.
They're simply raised as an Afghan or a Pakistani
Indian.
And they're in a Islamic country supposedly called as a Muslim. This person is very weak, like the foam of the sea. Anything can come in.
أي أحد جاءه كريشة في محب الريح ساقطة لا تستقر على حال من القرق.
There is no foundation to them. They're not rooted in anything. So that they're like a feather that could just be blown
away.
There are storms from every direction, from all the nations, from every
direction.
Sometimes it's China, Asia, France, America, whatever. Any of these storms that are battling, this person is blown into whatever direction. So France, don't worry about it. Give your ear to France if you're from, you know, most of West Africa or Mauritania.
And
if you're Egyptian, from Misr, then give your ear to the or the French or the British and Americans.
كلهم جيد يعني لا بأس.
Then both of those are fine. If you're a Saudi, then definitely give your ears and your obedience to your master.
لسيدك. إن كنت باكستاني وهندي يعطونك لسيدك بريطانيا هاي سيدتك وأم أبيك.
And if you're British or Indian, then understand that you have to obey your British.
إن كنت باكستاني وهندي فعليك أن تطيع بريطانيا.
You have to.
لا خيار. لا كلام للعبد مع سيده.
With no option, the slave does not speak against their master, Britain.
ولا أعرف ما يفعل أهوالنا. لا أعرف.
And as for the Afghans, I don't even know.
I think perhaps
every nation has a say in.
There's no
nation except that they turn them away, but there's no nation except that it came through their lands.
هذا هو الواقع. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أخبركم بهذا.
This is what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم warned you.
ماذا نحتاجه نحن المسلمون الآن؟
So what do we Muslims today need?
نرجع على التعليم الأول.
To go back to the first education.
التعليم الأول هو كتاب الله تعالى وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم بكلام العلماء العاملين الذين لا يلتفتون إلى أي ضرب ولا إلى أي شرط ولا إلى أي عرف يقدمون ما قال الله ورسوله على كل شيء.
To follow the authentic traditional Islamic scholars who neither turn to the east or turn to the west. They don't even worry about anybody in the
sky
or any type of culture or civilization nor any nationalism or Arabian nationalism or whatever it is.
يفكرون عن قول الله تعالى يوم يجمع الله الرسل فيقول ماذا أجبتم قالوا لا علم لنا.
That they know that they will be facing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the messengers will face Allah and once they are held to account and even the messengers will say we do not know, we have no knowledge.
يفكرون عن ذلك اليوم.
To ponder about that and to put themselves in that position.
كل واحد منهم يفكر أن هناك قضاء مع رب العالمين، قاض بين يدي رب العالمين. سيكلمه الله ويقول له يا أيها القاضي ويا أيها العالم ماذا أديت كالرسل؟ قال مالك بلغني أن العلماء تسألك ما تسأل الأنبياء واحدا واحدا ماذا قلت؟
That before they open their mouth, they realize they put themselves in that position.
قدر أنك ستسأل أمام رب العالمين.
They will be asked by the Lord of the Worlds. That as Imam Malik mentioned that it has reached me that
العلماء تسأل كما تسأل الأنبياء.
The scholars will be asked just as the
prophets. واحدا ماذا أجبتم.
One by one, what? How were you responded to? What did the
ماذا
people say?
قلتم.
What did you say to
ماذا
them?
ماذا علمتم.
What did you teach?
هل غيرتم أو بدلتم أو حرفتم.
Did you change or replace or distort?
هل هذه الرسالة التي في أيديكم أنتم ورثة الأنبياء هل أديتمها كما أداها الأنبياء؟
This inheritance that you received from the prophets, did you deliver it as you received it from
ولا يخافون لومة لائم.
Without fearing any blame from anyone.
لو تداعت الأمة كلها ولامتهم يقول لا نبالي.
If the whole nation stood against you. And blamed you that you would not care and you would deliver.
هذا كلام الله ورسوله. هذا كلام الأمة الإسلامية قالت هذا جيلا بعد جيل.
This is what Allah and His Messenger said, and this is what was passed down by the Muslims generation after generation.
هذا دين مسند من نبينا صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى يومنا هذا ولا تغيير فيه ولا تبديل.
This is a deen from Allah سبحانه وتعالى passed down from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to our time generation after generation.
واحد منهم يقول وارها لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لو وضعتم الدنيا الشمس في يميني والقمر في شمالي ما تركت هذا خلاص.
That he would say in accordance with what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, inheriting what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم taught, that if you place the sun in my right hand and the moon in my left hand,
لا أغير كلمة من شريعة لا.
I will not change a letter from the شريعة of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
أمسكوا ما لكم أو أعطوه لا أبالي بكم.
Keep your money, give me your money, don't give me anything, doesn't matter.
دخل المنصور على النبي على امام دار الهجرة مالك في المدينه المنصور الخليفة ابن هارون الرشيد الخليفة على عامة المسلمين.
So the Khalifa al-Mansur
جاء إلى المدينة زائرا.
He came to Medina on a visit.
فدعا مالكا.
At the time of Imam Malik, and he called Imam Malik to him.
وأرسل إليه فجاءه مالك أرسل إليه بغلته الخاصة التي يركبها بغلته مركوب الخاص سيارة الخاصة.
He sent the special mount, the presidential, the
مركبه الخاص.
The Khalifa's special mount. He sent it to Imam Malik so that he would come on it to be to come.
ردها إليه وقال إنه لا يركبه في المدينة.
So then he sent it back to him. He said that I don't ride in Medina.
وهو في ذلك الوقت مريض لا بد له من أن يسرده الإنسان.
Amen.
مريض.
نعم. Imam Malik at the time he was sick.
لا بد له من الناس يسندونه يمشي معه.
He needed people to actually lean on while he was.
فجاء بين رجلين يتهادى بينهما.
So he sent the mount back and he came walking, leaning between two men.
ما كان يلبس النعل وما كان يركب الحافرة في المدينة.
And as is known about him, he did not wear shoes or ride any mount inside.
قال كيف يفعل ذلك في أرض مشى فيها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأصحابه.
And he said, how could I do such a thing in a land where the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
ولا يقضي الحاجة في حرم المدينة مطلقا.
And his companions walked upon, and as such, he did not even use the bathroom where he lived without leaving the area. Ever.
حتى ينتهي من حرم المدينة.
Until he leaves the haram.
فلما جاء إليه كلم وقال والله إنك تركت بغلتهم وجئت الرجال يحملونك هذا أشرى من البغال.
So then he said that the Mansur, once he saw him being leaning on two men, he
Subhanallah.
Said, Subhanallah, you left the special executive mount. And you came being carried by two men, and men are more noble than a mule.
فكلمه وقال ألك حاجتنا أيها الإمام يا أبا عبد الله.
So then he said, do you have
أي حاجة أعطيك إياها.
Tell me anything, I'll give you what you need.
قال لا أحتاج منك أي شيء.
He said, I don't need anything from you.
عليك بأهل المدينة أوصيك بهم خيرا.
But I advise you to treat the people of Medina with goodness too.
فإن من أرادهم بسوء أذابه الله تعالى كما يذاب الملح.
Because whoever seeks to harm the people of Medina, Allah dissolves them like salt is dissolved in water.
فأرسل إليه المنصور هديته. أموالا مالا.
And Mansur, he sent a great gift of wealth to Imam Malik.
فتركها مالك وهي في غلافها.
And he left it unopened.
فأرسل إليه بعد ذلك ليطلب منه تخصيصا للدراسة.
And then after that, he sent a request. For special education.
لتدريسه ولتدريس أولاده خصوصية وطلب منه حوائج خاصة.
To teach his children
بالخصوصية.
Private classes.
وطلب منه أمورا.
And he asked for him some certain matters.
فرد إليه الظرف من حالته.
So he sent back to him the money that he had sent.
بحاله بخاتمه.
Unopened with its seal.
وقال له يا أمير المؤمنين العلم يؤتى ولا يأتي.
So he said, O leader of the believers.
أولادك كعامة المسلمين يدرسون معهم فقط.
Knowledge is approached and it doesn't come to you. Your children will be like the rest of the ummah. They have to come and learn knowledge the same like everybody else learns.
وأراد الخليفة أن يرفع صوته كحال الأمراء في مسجد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the Khalifa wanted to raise his voice as the leaders do in the message of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قال له يا أمير المؤمنين أغض من صوتك.
So Imam Malik told him respectfully, O leader of the believers, he addressed him. He said, lower your voice. Lower your voice. This is the message of the Messenger. Do you not know you are in the message of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam?
قال إن الله أدب أقواما.
Then he said, Allah has chastised a certain
people.
And has ridiculed or criticized a certain people. And he criticized a certain people. Allah admonished a certain people, criticized a certain people, and praised a certain people. Those who Allah has warned, admonished, and taught. Allah says that
يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا ترفعوا أصواتكم فوق صوت النبي.
That all you who believe do not raise your voices over the voice of the prophet.
ولا تجهروا له بالقول كجهر بعضكم لبعض أن تحبط أعمالكم خوف أن تحبط أعمالكم تكفرون بالله.
Loudly to him as you speak to one another.
وأنتم لا تحبط أعمالكم وأنتم لا تشعرون.
So that your actions do not become nullified.
بكافر. بكافر.
Meaning that ستكون كافرا. Without you even realizing.
وأنتم لا تشعرون.
While you do not even realize.
ومدح أقواما فقال إن الذين يغضون أصواتهم عند رسول الله أولئك الذين امتحن الله قلوبهم للتقوى لهم مغفرة وأجر عظيم.
That as for those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has praised, Allah says, indeed, then the verse after it, indeed those who lower their voices in front of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah has tested their hearts, proven in their hearts, their taqwa, their piety towards Allah and their God consciousness, and for them is forgiveness and a great reward.
ولما أقواما فقال إن الذين ينادونك من وراء الحجرات أكثرهم لا يعقلون.
And those who
يرفعون أصواتهم يا محمد ويا فلان صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Criticize, but indeed those who call you from behind the rooms, from behind the walls. And meaning it's even from like just a few feet away that they would call behind the wall, they loudly.
أكثرهم لا يعقلون.
Allah says that those most of them they do not comprehend, they do not think, they do not have. Proper reasoning.
استكان المنصور استكان دخلت عليه السكينة.
Imam Malik told المنصور this.
استكان.
Calm down.
فقال يا أبا عبد الله إذا أردت دعاء أستقبل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأستقبل الكعبة.
So then he said, Oh Father Abdullah, meaning Oh Imam Malik, if I want to make dua here, should I face the Kaaba? Should I face the Qibla? Or should I face the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? So then Imam Malik responded. He said, "Then how could you turn your face away from him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, while he is your means to Allah and the means of your father Adam from before? Rather, turn your face towards him."
هذا هو الإسلام. ناس ثبتت في قلوبهم تعظيم ثبت في قلوب تعظيم الإسلام احترام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم استخدم حتى البلد لا يقضون في الحج حتى لا يلبسون في نعالهم. أما نحن الآن ماذا يفعلون المدينة ومكة ماذا يفعلون؟
So this was the people. These were the people who in their hearts was firm their belief in Allah سبحانه وتعالى, their respect for the
حتى الأرض أرض الحرمين مقدسة عندهم.
And even the land and the dirt, the earth of that land was respected and sacred to them.
صار رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في قلوب شيء لا يمكن أن يتخيله أحد.
From their appreciation and their respect out of their faith, their in Allah, their respect for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم reached levels that people today cannot even imagine.
ماذا يفعل الآن أهل الحرمين؟
But what do the people of the Haramain do today?
يستقبلهم وفد من أمريكا يعطونه طريق خاص وفنادق خاصة واحترام خاص والسلام خاص.
Once a people from America over there or from the West, they give them the special hotels and the special encampments and everything.
ولا يقدرون على كلام الله بالإنجليزية حتى لا يبقى للعربية أثر ولا الإسلام.
And they do not speak with them except in English, so that they do not leave.
احتراما حتى لا يكون هناك للإسلام أي مقام.
So that there is no position or standing for Islam after that.
وكأنهم يسكنون في قرية نعوذ بالله والعياذ بالله قرية بدوية وهذا العالم المتقدم العالم الأول.
As if they are in a Bedouin area and
المدينة كان مقرية بدو.
As if they are in the Medina, which in their minds is a Bedouin area, and that the real civilization is from the West.
الحضارة جاءتكم أمريكا.
So now the civilization has come to you. You better. Act like them so they accept
معاملة خاصة
special treatment
احتراما للكافرين فقط
special treatment special respect
لكفرهم بالله تعالى فقط
only for the disbelievers
لا أعرف لماذا
I don't know why
أنا لم أرى شيء آخر غير أنهم كافرون بالله
I don't see anything except that they are disbelievers in Allah
أي شيء تحتاجه السعودية
what does Saudi Arabia need from
المال لديهم ماذا يريدون
They have their wealth. Who are they trying to impress?
طمع فقط في احترامهم لجاههم فقط.
just seeking their honor and so they feel validated. They have an inferiority complex, and once they receive validation, then they'll feel better about themselves.
وجعلوا هذا الرسول الكريم ماء وأرضه وحرمه وقومه لا يمسون أهل ما عنده خير لا ما عنده أي خير ما عنده أي خير ما عنده أي خير.
But a person who does not have in their hearts the proper respect for the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم for this deen.
احترم له أرضه ودينه وقومه وعلاقته.
That he respects his people, he respects his land, he respects his relatives. You respect everything
associated.
There is no goodness in this person whatsoever.
لا خير فيه. سمى نفسه دولة إسلامية أو رجل إسلامي هذا لا فائدة فيه لا خير.
Whether he calls himself a Muslim person or a Muslim country or whatever, it doesn't matter.
هذا لا فائدة فيه. هذا ضيع وقته. هذا ضيع وقته.
There's no benefit in this person. He has wasted his time.
مالك رحمه الله تعالى سأله عن واحد قال تريبة المدينة فقط نقص تراب المدينة.
Then one person in front of Imam Malik, he was asked, he was asked about the one who says to use a diminutive term in regards to the dirt, of Medina. Instead of saying the turab or turbatul Medina, to say turaybatul Medina. Like it's a smallifying term. A diminutive means like a smallifying term.
قال هذا يلزم يلزم القاضي أن يؤدبه.
He said that the judge should punish this person.
قالوا يا أبا مالك شددت في الأمر يا أبا عبد الله. هل في شدة؟
He said, oh father Abdullah, oh Imam Malik, you this is a severe answer.
قال لا ما حقه أن يقتل.
He said no, rather it may be fit for that person.
ما حقه حقه أن يقتل.
He said actually no, because this person would be deserving of being killed.
كيف أرض ضمت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقال لها تريبة؟
That how is the
أرض
the land that
ضمت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم جسم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم
carried and includes and encapsulates the body of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. How can it be spoken down upon?
هذا هو الإيمان هذا هو الإيمان هذا هو الحب هذا هو التعظيم.
This was iman. This was love. This was the glorification.
هذا إذا وصل المسلمون إلى هذا الحد هذا هو الإيمان الحال هذا هو الإيمان وقبل ذلك ناس تتقمهم الأمم يعني كل واحد يعطيها رأيه فتحترم وتحب فقط لأن ما عنده شيء ما عنده الإيمان ليس بخالص.
This is the iman. This is the reality. If people this appreciation and love did not enter their heart, then they will be those people who are just trying to please other than Allah Subhanahu wa Taala trying to. Please, the West and try to. Islam from that for them is a just simply an idea that they can assume or reject or accept or whatever. That there's room for doubt in it. So now you see the means that were fixed with that from the Muslims having their strong foundation, how they were weakened when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for them to return towards. To the strangeness of deen, that the means that was there, that was given to them was?
تداعت الأمم.
And this, the different nations, the different nations were able to overpower them was?
تداعت الأمم بإسقاط هذا الدين لرده إلى الغرابة.
By their weakening of their appreciation.
وتبديل دين الإسلام كفرا.
And respect for their deen. That now they were able to take advantage of this strangeness and this estranged state and doubts that the Muslims now had accepted. And they tried a lot of different ways and they thought long and hard about how to corrupt
Muslims.
And one of the first means that they used to corrupt the Muslims was to establish public schools with their curriculums in the Muslim lands. And to ingrain in the framework of thinking for the intellectuals
and
the Islamic modern Islamic
thinkers
to establish these types of thinking
هذا المفكر الإسلامي هذه خطة غربية هذا المفكر الإسلامي خطة غربية
for the intellectual community in all of the Muslim lands.
مفكر الإسلام معناها يمكن أن يغير الأمكنة عن ويبدل كاليهود والنصارى ويقنع العوام بالكفر بدل الإيمان هذا هو معنى المفكر.
So now what did this lead to? Islamic thinker. Now a person.
معنى المفكر لا بد أن تفهموا معنى مفكر الإسلام.
You have to understand what a person who, mashallah, is a master of Islamic thought and is an Islamic philosopher or thinker today.
That مكفر إسلام.
What they are basically designed and crafted is.
من يقدر على تغيير عقليات العوام بسهولة.
Who is a genius level of intelligence, who has learned the deen and so on, who now is able to use this knowledge to craft complex arguments. And simple arguments in order to confuse the people and to convince
العوام يأخذ عقولهم بسهولة
of misguidance and to create a foundation for that misguidance so that the people and to take advantage of the ways the people think to craft those arguments that misguide the people and misguide the masses easily that, to tell them things that they will accept. With proof that they will accept this proof.
يعني يكون درس الفكرة الغربية وامتزجت معه وحاول أن يغير الدين بأساليب وجلس مع العلماء فعرف ما عرفه وعرف دسائس الإسلام وأين يخامنها وقلب الحقيقة عينا أخرى.
So they imbibed Western philosophy and thinking and combined this knowledge with the knowledge of Islamic proofs and so on, as well as knowing people's doubts and knowing their way of thinking and so on, to come up with arguments that are appealing and are accepted by the masses to that can misguide them away from the truth. That even the people who are called scholars today begin to accept these thoughts. So that they now began to baffle and confuse the so-called Muslim scholars to make a mockery of them in front of the people. Because these are not really scholars. These are ignorant people who are saying that they're scholars. And now once they're faced with this, they don't know how to respond and they become confused or accept it so that they become ridiculed and mocked in front of the people.
أنا سمعت بأذني ماذا يقول من أشهرهم.
And I'll give you
من أشهرهم.
From the most famous of speakers of the Muslims here in America, he said this. I heard him with my own ears.
ورأيته بعيني.
And I saw him with my eyes.
قال أنا لم أرى في بلاد المسلمين حتى من العهد القديم من هو قادر على معنى التفسير إلا قليل زل قليل من US من أمريكا. أنت تسمعه سعودية. قال الناس اللي يفهمون القرآن فهما يعني قويا وفهم حقيقي ويوقعونه على الوقائع الآن ويوضحون غيبياته هذا لا يوجد أحد منهم حتى المفسرين القدماء إلا قلة من يؤس.
He said.
أنا
that the people who can properly understand the Quran and place every verse where it belongs and really take with its modern context, to really grasp it in a way that they understand it in its modern context. I have not seen anybody who can do this except a handful of people here in the US. And the immigrants are listening to them in amazement, saying, wow, that makes sense. You know what wow means in the Mauritanian dialect?
يا ألمة.
نعم.
أنت يقول الإنسان عند الألم.
Yeah. That it's an expression of pain.
ليس كما تقول 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 يقول الإنسان عند الألم. واو واو واو. يا ألمة حيث المسلمين يعتقدون هذا المجرم من عامة المسلمين.
That they would say that that this is such a pain that the Muslims accept such an individual as being a Muslim.
فكيف يتعجبون من كلامي؟ وكأن المسلمون متى الإسلامية احتاجت الغرب الآن؟ كأن الأمة الإسلامية احتاجت الغرب الآن ليوضح لها كتاب الله وسنة نبيه.
As if the Muslim Ummah today needs the West to explain to them what really Islam has been telling them all along.
أأنتم في شنون وغفلة؟
Are you an insane and
أم أنتم الأغبياء؟
Or are you that stupid?
تعتقدون أن أمريكا توضح لكم الإسلام أو فرنسا أو أوروبا؟
That you think that you need America or France or Europe to explain to
you? يوضحون لكم كلام الله وسنة نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم.
To clarify to you the words of Allah and the teachings of His Messenger.
هذا قلب الحقائق.
This is the opposite of reality.
قلب الحقائق أمريكا يفهمون الناس الإسلام.
This is, you know, opposite world.
اللهم إن فهمت الإسلام خلال أمريكا فخذني إليك الليلة قبل المغرب.
Oh Allah, if I understand Islam from
اللهم إن فهمت كلمة واحدة أو فهما واحدا من الإسلام خلال أمريكا فخذني إليك قبل المغرب.
But even if I understood one statement or one Islamic matter only from the West, that they explained it to me, finally, this is what it means. That oh Allah, take me to you, take me away from this world even before the sunset tonight.
لا خير لا خير في حياتي في هذا. أنتم المسلمون أغبياء ما عندكم عزة الإسلام.
So then you Muslims then are then foolish for not having the pride in your Islam.
14 قرنا و40 سنة تداولت علماء الأمة مشرقا ومغربا من الهند إلى فرنسا. تقول أنتم الآن أنكم ستفهمون الإسلام خلال دكاترة من الغرب.
That you are saying that you'll understand Islam from doctors in the West now and the
Muslims. 14 قرنا و40 سنة.
Been passed down for generations and centuries. 1440 years. It's being passed down
من الهند إلى الغرب.
From India, from the far east to the far west, and you're saying that now it needed all that time just so doctors.
نحتاج جيلا درسوا في أمريكا جيلا هذا.
Doctor so and so from the west can tell us.
قوم درسوا هنا في أمريكا حتى يفهموا الناس الإسلام.
Or even people who studied here in America to teach people what Islam.
أنت تعلم هذا سمعتكم.
نعم.
أنت الآن أنت تعلم. كيف تفهم الإسلام من أمريكا وأنت أمريكي؟
قال لي شخص هو تخرج من أكبر جامعة في أمريكا قال وهو تخرج من درس الإسلام هنا قال هم لا يعلمون من الإسلام بهذا هارفارد إلا ليعطوا الناس الوجهة النظر أن الإسلام شيء رجعي ولا بد أن يغير.
أنت وأنت في شك مما قال الله؟
لا
أنت في شك مما قال الله؟ عندك شيء؟
لا
ماذا قال هو؟
قال أنه
كل لهم رجاء أنا لا أحتاج إلى رأيك ولا
أحتاج. I don't need your opinion. I don't need your clarification.
بئس الناس.
What terrible people! There is a brother who graduated, studied Islam in Harvard University, and he said that that the first thing I was suspicious when I was listening to him in the beginning, and the first thing that he said that the reason why they teach Islam in these universities is to convince the Muslims that Islam is backwards as it was practiced and needs to be changed in order to enter into modern times. That's it. That's the reason why they teach Islam. So are you in doubt in what Allah has said? That are you in doubt in what Allah has
said?
Are you in doubt?
ستفهمون الإسلام من النصارى واليهود?
You're going to understand Islam from Christians and Jews?
ما أغباكم.
How foolish are you then?
ما أقبحكم أو من تلاميذ النصارى اليهود ما أقبحكم.
Or from the students or of the even the Muslim so-called students of the Christians and the Jews that you think that those.
الله تعالى يقول ولن ترضى عنك اليهود ولا النصارى حتى تتبع ملتهم قل إن هدى الله هو الهدى.
That Allah سبحانه وتعالى says that.
ولن.
They will never, the Jews and the Christians will never be satisfied with you until you follow their way. وهم قالوا على دينهم أن ما نجحنا إلا أن بدلنا في ديننا أشياء تحتاج أن تبدل فالإسلام أن يتقدم لا بد أن
نعم.
يتقدم فعلنا
نعم ولا حتى تتبع ملتهم التحريف حتى تتبع ملتهم
their way is distortion and changing. So in fact the Rand Corporation did publish that just for Islam to enter into modern times it needs to be willing to jettison the ballast of the traditionalist understanding and to enter into modern times, to sacrifice even some of the foundations to enter into modern times.
أنا كل ما يقال للدكتور أو المحامي أعطيه كتابه لا أفتحه.
So as soon as somebody says doctor or lawyer or whatever, I give them back their book, I don't open it.
أو إذا فتحته أفتحه لأنتقده كاملا.
Or if I open it, and then I open it to criticize it entirely, to refute it from its beginning to its end.
لأريهم أنه غبي. كم عندنا أنا من كتب الدكاترة بيتي؟
To show him his error, to show him his foolishness. How many books of Dr. So and So do I have in
my house today? من بلاد العرب غيرها.
The people brought them to me from the Arab lands.
وأنت تعرف أن انتقدتها. أنت تعرفها.
And you know that I refuted them.
قرأتها وقلت له هذا أصل له ولا فعله.
And I read it and I said that this has no foundation and no
لا أصل له ولا فعله.
There's no.
فصارت هديتهم وبانا عليهم.
And doesn't and it's a proof against them.
صارت هديتهم وبانا عليهم.
And it became a destruction for them and a proof against them.
هؤلاء لا أثق بهم ولا ألتمس منهم أي خير. كل من يحمل شهادة غربية ويعتزت بها لا أثق به ولا أعتقد فيه خيرا.
So those people who
كل من يحمل شهادة غربية يتعزز بها أحب لا أثق به ولا أحترمه.
Every single person who carries a Western degree and takes pride in it.
يتعزز بها.
And they take pride in it in that.
لا أثق بشيء منه ولا أحترمه.
I do not respect him. I do not trust him in anything.
ولا أعتبر له كلمة واحدة في الإسلام.
And I do not take any seriously any opinion he has in Islam.
ولا أخذ منه توجيها إلا بعد التنقيح والتحقيق.
And I do not take from him any suggestion or word until I evaluate it first and I make sure that it's.
ولا أخذ من شأن إلا وأتهمه بالخسارة فيه.
And that I do not hear from him anything except that I run it by him suspicious of and I accuse.
إلا وليتهمته قوية فيه أنه ليس على الحق.
That I have a very strong suspicion that they are not upon the truth.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا يبدأ المؤمن من جحر مرتين.
As the Prophet Allah سبحانه وتعالى says that the Jews and Christians will never be satisfied until you follow their way, and their way is distortion, so they want the Muslims to follow that way. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that
لا يبدأ المؤمن من جحر مرتين.
The believer is not stung from the same hole twice.
أنا جربته عندما أتيتنا عرفت الطوائف كلها.
So I tested them. I experienced that from them once I came here. I saw all the factions and all their politics and their
agendas.
And I have not found any group except that it has a glaring flaw in its
belief.
And some political agenda that it is trying to push. So because of this, I do not expect any goodness from them.
لأن الله تعالى يقول ولا تلبسوا الحق بالباطل وتكتموا الحق وأنتم تعلمون.
Because Allah says, do not cover the and mix the truth with falsehood and hide the truth while you're.
والله ما وثقت بأحد ولو قال لي مالك أشعري سني ورأيت درس ما وثقت بطائفة منهم حتى في موريتانيا.
I swear by Allah, I did not trust any of these people. Even if they say we are a Maliki, we are an Ash'ari, we are from Ahl-Sunnah, even in Mauritania.
Wallahi la athiq bihim.
I swear by Allah, I do not trust them.
Walam ahmil shay'an minhum ala as-salama.
And I do not hold anything that they deliver and that they publish to be safe and free.
Wama qabaltu ta'ifatan minhum illa wa a'taqid anna hunaka khalfiyat.
And there is no group of them except that I see the behind the scenes workings going on in what they're saying.
فَأَنَا لَا أَغْتَرْ بِأَوَلَنْ يُغَيَّرَ النُّحَاسِ مَنْ ذَهَبْ نُحَاسِ وَيَقُولَ لِلنَّاسِ ذَهَبْ لَا أَغْتَرْ بِالْأَسْمَاءِ.
So I'm not deluded and by their names and by their titles.
لَا يَهُمُّنِي السُّنَّةُ وَالْجَمَاعَةُ مَالِكِيَّةُ شَوَافِعِيَّةُ لَيْسَ مُهِمًّا عَنْدِي.
Doesn't matter whether you call it copper or brass, you call it gold, it's still what it is.
وَلَنْ يُغَيِّرَ النُّحَاسَ مَنْ ذَهَبْ نُحَاسُ وَيَقُولَ لِلنَّاسِ ذَهَبْ.
So it can call a person Maliki or Ash'ari or whatever, it doesn't make
Shafi'i, Hanafi,
whatever you want to call
them.
Tell me your Abu Hanifa.
أنت مالك بن أنس.
In himself.
قل لي لك أبو بكر الصديق.
Tell me Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, it doesn't matter.
أنا ما عندي مشكلة. سمي ما شئت.
Call yourself what you want to call yourself.
لن أثق بك.
I will not trust you.
سميك أبو المشاكل.
I'll call you not Abu Bakr, Abu al-Mashakil, the father of the problems. There's no goodness. So long as you have a group or so long as you have a group or organization or association that you're calling to, then me and you are not going to get
it.
that a title is a title that is deviating people from
هذه الجماعات وهذه الجمعيات التي جاء منها الغرب واسسوا مدارس اسلاميه في قعر مراكز قبلة العلم كالازهر وكمثل الحرمين الشريفين والشام فاسسوا معاهد يسمونها اسلامي ومدارس اسلاميه ادخلوا فيها النظام الغربي.
These groups and associations that entered and infiltrated into Muslim organizations and lands and established universities and even entering and taking over Al-Azhar University and so on, what did they implement?
All they did.
And in the Haramain, in Mecca and Medina, and in Morocco, and in the Levant,
all of
they infiltrated every single of one of those universities, even the oldest Islamic universities that were established at the time of the followers of the companions.
كمن الزيتونة القديمة.
The old Zaytuna in Tunisia. That every single one of these they infiltrated, and the proof of that is look what they implemented. They implemented a degree system based on the Western education, and they abandoned the traditional way of transmitting knowledge.
فلما تحكموا من هذا علموا أن نظامهم سرى في جميع دول المسلمين وأن الدراسة النظامية هي الأصل وأنها بدونها لا يحترم أحد.
So then it became a degree-focused education rather than a knowledge and merit-focused education that is passed down through approval and not through just simply passing tests or barely passing some classes. Then and everybody can say what they want after that. Once this type of schooling system that is called like a whatever academic system that was is established, once they came to disrespect the traditional way of knowledge and to replace it with this degree system, and they began to respect the people of degrees, and if a person has a degree, that person is respected, and without it, they are not. Once they gained that type of mentality, then that's it. That was establishing fully the Western type of thinking that they took away the way that was leading to success, and they thought their success is in something that leads to their destruction.
وقام بذلك بعض فطعمت الناس وعات تستهين بحرمات الله تعالى كالحرمين والأنبياء وغيرها صارت فكرة غربية كل واحد يتكلم ويبدي رأيه ويحدث الأقوال الخطيرة التي تقدمت وردها العلماء وخلاص صار الإسلام نهبة.
And this was what they viewed as their success was their destruction, and it was the success of the plans of the enemies of Islam and the manifestation of their plots against the Muslims, that now the Muslims viewed this as respectable, that now what the Islamic academic environment became, one that encourages contradicting the tradition and coming up with more modern and innovative ways to explain away why we have to follow the same Islam that has always been practiced, that this is what became respected and this is
what.
And everyone now who is gaining these types of degrees and speaking of that is the person who is respected and accepted. And the disrespect now goes towards the one who is implementing the proper traditional knowledge and the things that the Muslims have venerated and accepted for centuries. So then they established alternative ways of thinking and evaluation and so on to compete with and defeat the traditional knowledge So they used and established more credibility by promoting things that show, look, we came up with a better understanding of the Quran and so on than all of those generations past, and use that credibility to against the Muslims in order to spread all the and they mixed in along with things that people made sense and they liked. Then they started to mix in the types of blasphemy of kufr, that a person is trusting this person because they're saying nice things, and then they enter into that matters of disbelief, finally crafted arguments so that the people enter into disbelief without knowing. That, so Islam, then the true Islam returns to Islam.
strange matter that it began, it was not, is no longer the norm, and the West rests after that. So whoever is saying the truth, now they're viewed as... And the majority is contradicting and opposing. And then now the general public, the masses, the laymen, they are saying that, look, this is what the majority is following, and this is what our mashallah, our elders or leaders are following. So then what are this guy, what's he saying? He's contradicting everybody that we know and everything that everyone's doing. So he's opposing the majority. Why would we follow
him?
The old knowledge, the old books, that traditional knowledge is
dead.
And then what people, the students, and the brightest students are being offered are the fruits of those corruptors. They're being taught, in fact, the curriculums and the books of the Orientalists and of the students, the Muslim supposed students of the Orientalists. And the only times you see them opening any of the traditional books of knowledge is when they are translated and corrupted by the modern. That's even if they open them. Or they summarize them and now they're entering their corruption even into the translations of those old books and traditional books. That even they distort, if you look at the publications from some famous
Muslims.
I do not know of any crime
جريمة.
That a parent does. A child abuse that is greater than entering them into public schools or into universities. I don't know of any child abuse above this, any crime above this that they can do against them. But this will enter them into Christianity or Judaism or most likely atheism without any doubt.
وهذا مصداق لقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من مولود لا يولد على الفطرة لكن أبويه يهودانه أو ينصرانه أو يمجسانه.
That as this is in agreement with what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
كل مولود يولد على الفطرة.
Every child is born upon the clean nature of believing in Allah's oneness, and their parents either make them toward being a Jew. Or a Christian, or a fire worshipper. And it's not legal for a person to tell a Muslim, leave Islam.
But they
would say, hey, I'm a Muslim, you can't say this to me. But now establishing an educational system and a way of thinking that now that leads towards that disbelief, that is fine. That makes easy for them the path to disbelief. That teach them step by step and feed them morsel by morsel until they are falling into this hole without even realizing it. Without even feeling. And they will think themselves that
they're so.
And in fact, they will think that they are so advanced and deep in their understanding of
Islam.
And they even go and become da'is to their wrong understanding.
So now in. إذن هذه أيام أيام الغربة.
So these are the days where Islam has returned to being strange
again. وصعب على الناس أن يفهموا الغيبيات ويصدقوا الأشياء التي لا يرونها.
And people are in
المعارضين والتشكيك.
That like the state the companions began in, where it was still they needed all of those years of fixing their mentalities that were had absorbed the years of paganism and so on that had been they had been exposed to in their parents and so on.
لكثرة المعارضين والمحاربين والمشككين.
So that beginning stage of Islam, that's the stage that Muslims are in today, and this is why.
من كثرة المعارضين والمحاربين والمشككين.
Because of all of the, you have opposition people who are attacking Islam.
والسياسيون المدربون على هذا.
You have the leaders of Islam who are corrupted. You have the politicians who have their agendas. You have every single avenue. You have the Islamic teacher who is corrupted. You have the teacher who is teaching a wrong mentality. You have from every single avenue there is a corruption.
هناك مخططات أنت ما علمتها وما حضرتها وما عرفت متى أسست.
And there are plots and plans that are being implemented against you, and you do not even know where they're from and where they were established.
أنا أعرف علماء درسوا في موريتانيا وخرجوا منها قبل ميلادي.
And I know of scholars who learned in Mauritania and left it before I was even born.
لم أراهم إلا هنا في أمريكا.
I did not see them except here in America.
أو في بلاد الخليج.
Or in the Gulf countries.
والآن من هؤلاء الدعاة.
And they're from those types of leaders nowadays.
لأن هذه فكرة طويلة هي من زمن طويل وأصحابها لا يقودونها الآن في الثمانينات والسبعينات والستينات ليسوا ناس أطفال.
Because the people
اشتهروا عند الناس وثقت بهم الناس.
Because the people who were born and raised into this wrong mentality and completely were following this agenda and are implementing it, they're not young, they're not born a few years ago. No, they're 80 years old, 60 years old. They've already had their impact on the people. That they took the introduction from a long time ago, that the baton was passed on to them. And their reputation has spread in the lands, and they use this to continue those ways and to push those agendas amongst the people.
ليس
so the matter is not simple. It's not an
easy. هذه الحرب مؤسسة من السبعينات السنين ثمانية تسعينات السنين بل ولا
This is from 80, 90 years ago, over 100 years ago.
فلا بد لها من فهم.
So it needs proper understanding.
المدارس أنا قلت وللمدارس النظاميات في محو الإسلام هنا دورات.
So then in these public schools and
أنا قلت وللمدارس النظاميات
in this poetry of
في محو الإسلام هنا دورات.
And I said in this poetry of mine that in this this type of education, these academic systems, that
في محو الإسلام هنا دورات.
There are so many programs
دورات عميقة
designed to erase Islam.
وسأتكلم عن هذا النوم الذي كتبته سأبين فيها خطورة الكفريات التي يعيشها الناس الآن وسأجعلها في الموقف.
In those matters, I will, inshallah, explain those matters in this poetry that I wrote. But in regard to this matter, this weakness is what has led people to having difficulty accepting those matters of the unseen, just as they needed years and years. Just as the companions needed, because they are also in a state where Islam is strange.
نحن الآن في غربة الإسلام. لا بد لنا من رجال يعطون الوحي على أسلوبه الأول. يغيرون فكرة عقول المجرمين المشككين.
So we need now, we're in a time that we are in need of people, of men, who are teaching Islam and establishing the ways of the traditional ways and the
ways لا تغيرهم عواصف السياسة لا يفكرون عنها.
The ways that the Muslims have practiced Islam for centuries and they are not affected, they are firm and unaffected by the storms that they are surrounded with of the disbelievers.
لا يفكرون عن استقبال السياسيين ولا أصحاب الجهة.
They don't care about the politicians amongst the Muslims or non-Muslims.
وجهاء العالم الإسلامي.
All of the different agendas from the people from the Islamic world.
مشاهير الدول الإسلامية.
They don't care about what the famous people in the Muslim countries are saying.
والله إنني أحقر عندي مشاهير المسلمين من الصبيان الذين يمشون على وجه الأرض. والله الذي لا.
I swear by Allah that.
والله الذي لا إله إلا هو.
I swear by Allah that there is no God but Him.
أحقر عندي.
That the leaders, the so-called leaders of the Muslims and the
مشاهيرهم.
The most famous Islamic speakers. those are more insignificant in my eyes than the little children that are
walking.
That a 10-year-old, I swear by Allah, that a 10-year-old child who has more weight in their statement. And from the day that I was born, I did not have any type of respect or glorification for them in my heart.
قال الشيخ محمد الحسن الخديم ولا تغن كهرة الأتباع دلت على العلم والاتباع.
As Muhammad al-Hasan al-Khadim, may Allah preserve him, said that don't think that having a lot of followers indicates that a person is righteous and or pious.
كثرة الأصدقاء لتخليط الدليل.
So the other side, he said that having a lot of friends is actually a proof that a person mixes the truth with falsehood, that they compromise a lot.
وقائل الحق صديقه قليل.
And the speaker of the truth, the one who says the truth, he has few friends.
قال أبو بكر رضي الله عنه كما في البخاري ما ترك الحق لعمر من صديق.
That Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه said in transmitted in Sahih Bukhari that the truth has not left for Umar any friends.
ما ترك الحق لعمر من صديق تركه واقفا وحده.
The truth has left Umar abandoned, standing on his own. Has not left him any friends.
The
Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah has placed the truth on the tongue of Umar.
وقلبه.
And his heart.
الحق حق.
The truth is the truth.
قال الفضيل بن عياض اسلك مع الطريق ولا يغرنك كثرة الهالك. كل الصلاة المستقبل.
الفضيل بن عياض, may Allah have mercy on him, said that take the path. Take the path and do not worry about seeing all that, you know, the abundance of the people who are destroyed and deviated along that path. The truth is the truth. Doesn't matter how many or how few people are following.
معنانا نحن في غفلة كما قلت لكم. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال بدأ الإسلام غريبا وسيعود غريبا. نحن في غفلة.
Of course, in a state of heedlessness. That as the Prophet ﷺ said, Islam began as something strange and it will return to be strange. The proof of a person's authentic nature in their Islam is that they are strange. They are away from the way of the majority today. That these matters are, I know that I've spoken about them for a long time, but these are very essential matters that are very much needed.
الواقع واقع لا بد أن نبينه.
The reality is the reality, and you need to clarify it.
فمن لا يعرف الواقع كيف يتعامل مع الواقع؟
Whoever does not know reality, how do they deal with reality?
هنا في تعرف هنا في بئريا في امرأة أفغانية طيبة ومتحجبة مسكينة وتحب الدين. فبنتها قالت لها إذا أردت أن تصلي صلي إلى الشرق. امرأة طيبة.
That mashallah, there's a lady in the Bay Area.
مسكينة,
mashallah,
مسكينة.
Nice, simple. She respects those who she calls the scholars, and she wears a hijab.
قبلت قولي لا
but if she accepts my statement, then she would not respect any of them.
المهم أنها مسكينة طيبة القلب.
But anyway, she's a soft-hearted person, and her daughter told her.
قالت لها يا أمي استقبل القبلة الصحيحة هنا في أمريكا إلى الشرق.
Her daughter told her, oh my mother, you know the correct qibla here in America is east.
فقالت لها كيف هذا نعرف أنه صحيح ولكن الإجماع على أنها east.
So then she said, yes, okay, well, we can.
أنا ما أعرف أنا أصدقك.
Yeah, I believe you.
هذا صحيح.
It makes sense that the east is the qibla here in America.
ولكن تعارضت مع الإجماع.
But it's contradictory. The consensus of the scholars in America is on east.
أقول لكم كيف البلاد يصير مسلمين يعيشون.
That I'll tell you this. This is amazing.
أنتم المسلمون وأنا في هذه المرتبة.
That all Muslims who are in this place now understand. How do people reach the level of saying the consensus of Muslims in America? She said, well, the East direction is contrary to the consensus of the Muslim scholars in America. So now if somebody has this mentality, how do you talk to them?
إذا وصل المسلمون إلى هذه الدرجة من السقوط حيث يعتبرون ما في أمريكا طلاب علم فضلا أن يكونوا فقهاء فضلا أن يكون ينعقد بهم ينعقد بهم تنعقد بهم الصلاة فضلا أن ينعقد بهم نكاح زواج وما بالك بالجمع بالإجماع.
So then now it's already a matter of debate whether that these types of Muslims now that they are able to even be, you know, the matters of the responsibilities of marriage and of giving the proper nikah and
أو ممكن أن يصحح الصلاة
or even having proper prayer is you know that their prayer
فضلا أن يكونوا علماء
far away from them being scholars
فضلا أن ينعقد بهم الإجماع
far away from their opinion being counted towards a consensus or lack thereof Islamic.
والعلماء والإجماع لا يعد في الإمام القرطبي ولا الباجي ولا إمام الحرمين ولا حتى من الطبقات التي بعد الإمام مالك وأبي حنيفة.
And the great scholars like al-Qurtubi and al-Baji or Imam al-Haramain or even the scholars
Subki
after the time of Imam al-Hanifa. These scholars who reached these heights were the Imams of the Muslims. Their opinion wouldn't be counted for or against ijma.
لا يعدون في الإجماع.
So it doesn't matter even if they contradicted with the consensus, which they didn't.
لا يحسبون في العير ولا في النفي. قالوا أنتم طلاب علم جلستوا ما عندكم.
Their opinion would not be counted as a break from consensus because.
لا يضرونهم ولا يزيدونهم ما عندهم.
Where their opinion was taken into account to validate or invalidate consensus. So now forget about Subki and Al-Qarafi and Al-Qurtubi and all of these. Now they say
that
now they say, look, the West, these scholars have consensus. They said the Qibla is northeast. That's their consensus, right? Have the Muslims ever reached such a degraded state such as this? You know why she's saying this? Because she heard this from a lot of people. She said the scholar said this, what can we do? Because she doesn't know the meaning of a scholar then. As far as consensus is
concerned,
she doesn't know it. Even a scholar within a madhhab is called much
less consensus.
Ijma' is the consensus of the mujtahids. After the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's worldly life, that for ijma' to occur, it must be the consensus of the top scholars of who have reached the level of ijtihad, such as Imam Malik and so on.
أين السماء من نبح الكلاب؟ يا أيها الكلاب أين أنتم من نبح السماء؟ من صوت الرعد والسنة.
So then I would say to the dogs that are barking, how far is your barking away from the thunder in the sky?
إجماع في أمريكا.
Consensus in America.
لما اكتشفت أمريكا قال انقطع الإجماع لا يوجد إجماع لأن المجتهدين ليسوا موجودين.
من اكتشاف أمريكا. When America was discovered, where were the mujtahids?
انقطع الإجماع قبل.
The consensus has not been since before America was discovered by
قبل وجود أمريكا ماتوا المجتهدين ما بقي مجتهد من القرن الثامن قال سيدي عبد الله بن حجر لا يوجد مجتهد معروف
from the 8th century until now
ست قرون الآن
six centuries meaning the last
لا يوجد مجتهد الآن عرفه العلماء
there is not a known
لم يعرف العلماء مجتهدا خاصا إلى الآن
the scholars do not know of an agreed upon مجتهد from the last 600 years until now that's it
اسمعوا والمجمع اليوم عليه عندما مات داود الله قال العلماء جميعا والمجمع اليوم عليه الأربعة لأنه هو اللي تحقق اجتهادهم ولا نرى مجتهدا الآن والمجمع اليوم عليه الأربعة وقف غيره الجميع منعه حتى يجيء الفاطمي المجدد دين الهدى لأنه مجتهد.
So what was the understanding upon the passing of
ست قرون
600 years ago that's it that
لم يعرف العلماء مجتهدا من ذلك اليوم.
The scholars do not know of a mujtahid. If somebody wants to follow fiqh, They have only the four surviving madhabs from that time until the Mahdi comes.
صارت هناك احد العلماء في امريكا وينعقد بهم اجماع حتى تعرفوا اين وصلتم انتم لا تقرؤون العلم واحد يبلغ من البلاد هذا يحسب اطفال امريكا هؤلاء يحسبهم من جمله طلاب العلم هذا غريب جدا.
So this is a very strange matter in a very low state that a person is now considering these people who are barely or even not even students of knowledge as being such scholars that they're
فسيحسبهم على علماء الأمر الذين عقد بهم الإجماع.
That their statement is even taken into account in regards to a consensus or lack thereof.
قالت هذا إجماع المسلمين وأنا سمعته مرات العلماء قالوا هذا ماذا نفعل.
So then they said that I've heard this so many times in regards to the Qibla and other things that the scholars said this, what can we do?
ماذا نفعل.
What do we do?
يعني العلماء إذا قالوا ما عندنا خيار
يعني once the scholars say these things today, well, what can we do? We have to go with what they say.
هذا هو الذي قال لي شيخي حد من قال لي يا فلان ما أفسد هذا الدين إلا وضع المسميات على غير مستحق.
That helps us understand what my sheikh told me that he said, oh so and so, that what has caused the corruption in the deen today is that people have called things by other than their names.
المهم رجعنا إلى الرؤية فبالإنسان الأمور الآن الغيبية صعوبة لغرابة الإسلام رؤية الله تعالى بالأبصار تجوز عند أهل الاستبصار دون تقابل أو اتصال بل الذي يليق بالجلال الرؤية حق.
So then these matters are difficult for people.
صار صعبا صعبا لأن المجرمين الآن ما يسمون العلماء يشككون في الغيبيات ويجعلونها مجاز كوجود النار والرؤيا والجنة يخيلون الناس أنها مجازات.
The people have such a doubt in the matters of the unseen that in order to satisfy them, that the modern so-called scholars are explaining away every matter of the unseen and saying that they're just metaphors and so on. That you don't have to believe in them to lead people to blasphemy, such as the seeing of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. That over here, he says the vision of the people of paradise seeing Allah Subhanahu wa Taala is true. Without their visions encompassing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning without their what they see.
دون تقابل أو اتصال ليس نرؤية متصلة ضوئية أو تقابل أو لا.
Nor that their eyesight even reaches Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
ليس الله تعالى له مكان حتى تتصل الأشعة به.
That now as if you know that now you're.
دون تقابل كهكذا. أو اتصال ضوء رؤيتي.
Or نعم.
Direction.
نعم. دون تقابل أو اتصال.
That it doesn't need the seeing of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala doesn't need a direction or without taking into account anything in regard to the
modality. بل الذي يليق بالجلال.
A modality of how Allah Subhanahu wa Taala is seen. لكن. And while knowing that it is not encompassing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the visions do not reach Allah, they do not encompass Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that rather what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows the people to see of Him is now based on a manner that whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides to reveal to them and to show them and in a manner that is not encompassing Him and so on, and in a manner that is unseen and unknowable by us, and that's what we accept.
فجاءت طائفة الاعتزال ومعهم جماعة أيضا أخرى ممن ينتسبون إلى أهل السنة لآن وأهل الاعتزال والضلال قضوا بأنها من المحال قالوا مستحيل
and the معتزلة أعوذ بالله
وجماعات ضالة حتى منسوبة الآن إلى المسلمين
and even the people who call themselves Muslim today what they did is they tried to go and understand this logically to explain it logically and of course this is beyond a person's ability to even imagine and to see how it is going to be. So what they said is that it's impossible, so it's not going to happen. So because their understanding of seeing was that there's like rays that are shot out of the eyes that reach that thing that they are seeing and come back to them.
يفسر الرؤية بالشعاع وذاك في الباب الامتناع هذا اتصال الله تعالى بالجهة هذا مستحيل.
And then they said that okay, because this is how we understand vision, that there's no way that those rays can leave the eyes of a person and come back and reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and come back to them. That this was their understanding of
vision.
So they philosophized about what vision is, and based on their philosophy, they said that this is impossible. for us to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this manner. So then they denied what Allah revealed in order, based upon their philosophy. So they were in fact denying. And then the people who were between logic and scripture, who restrict the scripture in accordance with, who restrict the logic in accordance with the scripture, they understood that this is something that is unknowable, ununderstandable. And they said that clearly, that seeing... that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates for the person who is seeing a sight, something that what they see, that whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala... that allows them to see now.
هل عقولنا الآن تتصور أمكنة وهي ليس لها اتصال رؤية بها؟
But now can our minds even
عقولنا وقلوبنا
and our hearts can we imagine something that we never
ما
saw؟
ما اتصال به صحيح؟
That we have no connection with that we
صحيح يمكن؟
No, yeah, it is possible for us to imagine
ممكن.
Something a place we've never been to before or a place that doesn't even exist.
هل لا يقدر الله تعالى أن يجعلنا لا عيون وعلى البدن كامل مذهب السنة عقول وتترى كما ترى؟
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to create for the people and minds and eyes and anything in their body that doesn't that a witnessing of himself without any connection without any facing any direction.
ما هو الفرق بين كلام الجلود وكلام الأسئلة كما قال تعالى وقال الجلود ينشط معنا قال وانتقن الله ما هو الفرق بين فهم العقل وفهم العلم اللي أعطاه الله فهم.
So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the true creator of the effects. So the effect of speech, for example, people tie it to tongues. But then Allah can give that quality of speech to the skin and to the bones and to the hands and to anything that He wills.
Right?
And He could give sight and witnessing to anything else and allow it to witness whatever He wants to witness.
هذا واضح وكذلك الله تعالى إذا أخبر بشيء واجب أن نعتقدون أن الله تعالى لا يخبر بالمستحيل.
That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also can
الله تعالى أخبر بها قال وجوه يومئذ ناظرة إلى ربها ناظرة.
So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the faces that day will be brightened, looking towards their Lord. So then this is the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeing of Allah is something that is established in revelation.
وكون موسى سأل الجليلة في أمرها غدا لنا دليلا أيضا. كون موسى سأل هذا كيف يسأل موسى المحاط.
That and even the fact that Musa عليه السلام asked, "Oh Allah, allow me to see you."
لو كان شيء مستحيل كيف يسأله موسى؟
It is a possibility that Allah سبحانه وتعالى has the ability to allow someone to see him.
كيف يطلب المستحيل؟
So Musa عليه السلام, how would he ask something that is impossible?
مثله لا يجهل المحال في حق ربنا تعالى.
So
مثله لا يجهل المستحيلات في حق الله.
Someone like Musa عليه السلام isn't going to be ignorant of what is impossible.
وقد رأى خير الورد ديانا للأسرية به عيانا بالعنب المصحح المشهور هو الذي يدعى إلى الجمهور.
And the opinion of the majority is that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم himself saw Allah سبحانه وتعالى in the ascension.
قد رأى خير الورد ديانا ليلة أسرية به عيانا.
That he saw Allah سبحانه وتعالى and when he was ascended with. And this is the correct opinion of the two.
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وتفسيره على ما أراد الله أرد على ما أراد الله عندما نسمع إنما كان قول المؤمنين إذا دعوا إلى الله يا رسول يحكم بينهم أن يقولوا سمعنا وأطعنا تفسيره على ما أراد الله.
So then how do we interpret these verses that we will see Allah, that the believers will see Allah, that we interpret it according to what Allah سبحانه وتعالى says.
على ما أراد الله. وجوه
ناظرة إلى على ما أراد الله.
تفسير على ما أراد الله كيف الرؤية نحن لا نفكر عنها.
ذكرت آية أخرى.
وجوه ناظرة إلى ربها ناظرة.
لا على ما أراد الله قلت.
على ما أراد الله بدون شيء ولا ماكن فقط على ما يريد الله تعالى وقيا.
Basically, however, Allah, there was a verse that was about basically as Allah سبحانه وتعالى reveals it. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals to us that we accept. That Allah says we will see him, we'll see him.
وكل ما جاء في ذلك من الحديث الصحيح عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعن أصحابه رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين فهو كما قال ومعناه وتفسيره على ما أراد.
And everything that has come from from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is beyond our
understanding,
by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and passed down by the companions, it is as, may Allah be pleased with them all, it is as was revealed, and it is and its interpretation and its real meaning is based on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills by him. That's where we leave it, and we do not enter into those matters interpreting them according to our own limited understanding, or our opinions, or being deceived by our own whims and our desires. Because no one can be safe in their deen except those who submit the matters to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to His Messenger. And he left the knowledge of that is unknowable by him and only knowable by its knower to the one who knows it. And then Imam al-Tahawi mentions that your foothold in Islam is never affirmed except upon a foundation of submission and surrender.
ما علم ما فمن رام علم ما حضر عليه ولم يقنع بالتسليم فهمه ولم يقنع يقنع بالتسليم فهمه حجبه ورامه الخالص التوحيد.
That the foothold, your foothold in Islam can never be firm. This is the statement of Imam al-Tahawi. The foothold in Islam can never be firmly established except upon a foundation of submission and surrender, and the one who attempts to understand and explain that which is beyond the ability, beyond the human imagination, beyond the understanding of even that particular individual, then this person will and he is not content with saying, okay, I don't understand, and it's beyond my understanding, and it's true, but it's beyond my understanding. If he is not satisfied with just accepting and submitting to that which is beyond his understanding, then his curiosity and his lack of submission will be a barrier from him to understand and to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this will be a barrier from his belief in divine unity. And this will be a barrier from him having a pure understanding of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as oneness. And it will be a barrier between him and having correct iman. So this person who is not submitting his intellect to its capabilities and its boundaries, this person will be fluctuating between a state of belief and disbelief, between denial and acceptance, between rejection and following. That this person will be confused and lost, and he will have all these whisperings from himself. That he will be so doubtful, and he will be
misguided.
He will never be a believer who accepts, nor and he will not fall, and he will not
fall,
nor enter into a clear disbelief alone by this action, by his denial. And this state of wavering and fluctuation, this is the state of the majority, the vast majority of Muslims today. That I was sitting with an Iraqi man who is older than me, probably in his
60s.
That there is a great difference in our age. Maybe he's in his 60s right now, or 60 years old.
وكانت له زوجة نصرانية.
And his wife was Christian.
وأخلاقه طيبة ولكن استغربت يوما من حاله.
And his character was good, but I was puzzled by his state of being one day. He said that he does not know whether the Muslims or the Christians are the ones who are following the truth.
This is not... This
is
not...
This is not him alone. This is the purpose. This is what is desired by
these
perennialists who are the famous Muslim speakers today, who are teaching this belief that they're saying that all of the Christians, the Muslims, and the Jews are equal and these are all acceptable ways, and these are Abrahamic religions, and the faith is your faith in your heart, you believe in God and you want to do the right thing and you have sincerity in that, then it doesn't matter what type of
Muslim.
And they'll tell you that even these threats of hellfire,
and
they'll say that is what Allah scares his servants, that simply it is to deter. It is simply a deterrent, and in reality, no
one knows.
That simply the reason of their that they will lead you to say believe that, oh, this is just simply for this world, to scare people in this world, and there's no... And what is after that is so that people will not be... You will have mercy. Don't worry, the people of hellfire will be... Allah doesn't punish, and he's so merciful and
سبقت غضبه وأكثر رحمته من عقابه.
His mercy is greater than his punishment. And
يعني حتى تتخيل كل إسلام خرافات يعني.
So that you are led to the understanding that
خرافات فقط وقصص يعني.
Made up stuff and
قصص جحا أو ألف ليلة أو
like a thousand and one nights or
قصص جحا.
There are fairy tales that Islam is fairy tales and it's just stories.
هل حق؟
نعم.
هذا صحيح. معناه أن الإسلام لا نرجع قصص جحا وألف ليلة.
This is just one narrative. It's a story. It's the Islamic perspective.
And here's
what the philosopher said. Or the female, mashallah, Western, disbelieving philosopher, white person. He said, look, mashallah, how geniuses those people are. That they're such geniuses. That look what they said.
يا لتنهم قالوا أنا تعرفني أنا 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 تعرفني بالغ درجة من احتقار البيضة أصحاب الدكاترة عجيب بالغ درجة من احتقارهم وأريتهم أمام الجميع احتقرتهم احتقار عجيب أمام الجميع. أنا بالغ درجة من إهانتهم وفعلته.
And I have such a contempt for these, you know, European doctors.
هؤلاء عندي عليهم نوع من الإهانة ما ممنوع قلب.
I have such, my heart is filled with such a contempt and ridicule.
والله ما أتذكر من نظرت إليهم نظرة احترام.
That I swear by Allah, I do not, and I've put them in their place many times, and I swear by Allah that I do not remember one time that the greatness.
دخل في قلبي منهم احترام مطلقا.
And any respect for them.
أنا كنت أقول صديق قصة خال. تعرف في واحد كان يعني جاءنا بالزيتونة القديمة أنا أبدأ قصته الزيتونة القديمة وكانه يحمل هذه الشهادة الكبيرة لعله طبيب ومحامي وجاء إلى الزيتونة وكنا هناك يعرف زهاء 100 شخص و100 محامين وكانوا سامع عبد الله عنه يترجم عنه وهو ترجم جيد عبد الله عنه وحقق لنا وله الرحمة فترجم عني وقال نحن أنا أريد أسئلة عن الإسلام أنا نظرت إليه بجنب عيني وقلت تفضل.
So then one time, as I've mentioned this story before, we were in the old Zaytuna and a man entered, perhaps he had a very high degree from a respected university by these people, and he came in and he had such an arrogance that the people looked at him like, oh, this person has significance and value. I swear by Allah, I didn't even move from my spot. The person who was translating me for me was Osama. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help him towards goodness and pardon him. and grant us and him
mercy.
And he was an excellent translator. And so I looked to this man who came, obviously, you know, Anglo white guy, doctor, respected. I told him, go ahead, sit down. What's your question? I wasn't going to stand up and give him a place to say it. Just go ahead, sit and ask. What do you want? He said, I have several, contradictions or matters, criticisms of Islam or questions, basically. So he wanted to marry some Sudania or Afghania. He's going to marry a Muslim woman, maybe from Sudan or maybe from Afghanistan. Perhaps she was Sudanese. So he wanted to clarify these matters in Islam.
This was a known
thing amongst the Muslims.
There's
no problem that the families be like, okay, go ahead, have your boyfriend be a kafir. No, absolutely not. But before that, you know, he's sharing a bed with her for years. And then once, obviously, the person wants to come to Islam, then it's like, now you have to be a Muslim to marry. So he came to ask some questions. And he thought that nobody is going to be able to answer them. So I said, go ahead, ask. So he said that you Muslims, you put the authority in the hands of the man in the relationship. So I said, yes. Yes and yes. What's the problem? Should we give him the response? No.
مسؤوليته ومسؤوليته غيره. هل نعطيه مسؤولية يملكها أو مسؤولية لا يملكها؟
Do we give him a responsibility of a matter that is in his hands or it's not in his hands anyways?
أنتم الآن أي مكتب لا تعطون مسؤولية لشخص فيه فقط.
Now, what kind of office, what kind of standing?
هل لديكم أي مكتب؟
Any type of office, any type of office, which one do you have, or any company, or
كلكم سواء 50-50.
Everybody is equals in that organization or in that company.
No.
Or is there a person who is in charge?
Every
he said, of course, there has to be a leader. So then there has to be a manager. So then I said that, well, then a household and a family and this organization in which a person will be raised in this world, that there's no manager? Is that, can you comprehend that? So then who is the one who is responsible in
front of the Lord? ومن عليه الإيجار ومن عليه كل شيء ومن عليه تعليم الأطفال أي شيء
Islamically responsible for spending upon that family
كل شيء من أوله من ألفه إلى يائه
from A to Z who is responsible for the upbringing of that family
نحن لسنا أمريكان نحن المسؤولية نجعل الإسلام يتعالى على الرجل.
So we are not people who are just have an American mindset. We are Muslims. The one and what we have in Islam is that the responsibility in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is primarily upon the man. And he said, okay, I understand. Because as they say, you know, it makes sense if you don't think about it. There's a social type of understanding that people came to that it is wrong to say that the man has an authority. That the man has authority in a relationship or in a family structure. And this is...
فأنت اجلس هناك حتى تفهم الإسلام ونحن لسنا شركة في الرأي نحن لنا ديننا اجلس حتى نفهم ديننا.
So then people they don't question these things and they're raised, okay, it's wrong to think that the man has that authority. But when you sit down and think about it and you come and you say, okay, teach me your deen, why does this make sense? Then the matter clicks and you're able to understand easily. He said, okay, I understand. Now there's another matter that I have to criticize about Muslims, which is that you allow multiple wives.
نعم قلت أنا الآن أذكر إشارة هنا وقالوا جاكسون أسوأ شيء حسب ما رأيت في الدنيا.
And I told him that now I live on a street called Jackson Street or whatever.
وبئس المكان.
And what a terrible street.
هذا أسوأ مكان في الدنيا.
It's the worst place on earth. It's known for one thing.
وما بيني وبين هذه المدرسة التي أدرس فيها إلا أقل من دقيقة مشية.
That there's less than 1 minute between where I live and where the school that I teach is.
وأصلي خمس مرات في ذلك.
And I pray 5 times in where that school is.
وما مررت على هذا الشارع في وقت إلا ورجل يزني بامرأتي.
And every single time I pass by this Jackson Street, I see a man and a woman having a zina. There's prostitution. So do you understand
this?
Have you learned history?
هل رأيت في يوم من الدنيا إلا والنساء أكثر من ثلثين أو ثلاثة أرباع في العالم الإنساني؟
Have you seen in human history times where the women did not outnumber the men?
ثلثان ثلاثة أرباع تقريبا 70% أو 60 أو لا أقل من.
Or not more than 60% or 70%.
وخصوصا في هذه الأيام.
Especially these days.
والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أخبر ورأيناها بالعيان بادئة. سيكون للمرأة الواحد للرجل الواحد لخمسين مرأة الحديث البخاري مسلم القيم الواحد.
That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said about a day.
يكثر الهرج والقتل.
50 women.
مقابل كل 50 امرأة رجل واحد.
That for every 50 women there is one man.
حتى يكون يعني 1% فقط تقريبا.
That even it will reach to the point of one. Or 2% of the population will be male.
قلت له أنت ما ترى أتمر عدد الإنساني الآن النساء كم أضعاف من الرجال ألا ترى ذلك؟ إذا هو مسكين وبليد جدا وما يعرف ذا قد يكون يعرف ولكن من كثرة التفكير الناس غسلوا دماغه عندما نرى قال صحيح يعني هذا صحيح.
So that I pointed to this issue of the ratio of men and women that brings about one of the necessities that necessitates this matter. And besides that, is there even one of the men that they don't have like 20 women outside of their relationship? Before or after or during their marriage? While he's married.
نعم هذا تعرفونه جميعا ما تحتاج إلى تبيين.
You do not need any clarification.
إذا أنتم لا تعرفون أنتم صم بكم
أن لا تعقلون. If you don't know this matter, if you don't know that this is the reality of the world,
صم بكم أن لا تعقلون.
Then you must be deaf, dumb, and blind if you're not aware.
والنساء يعلمن أن أزواجهن يفعلن ذلك. هن يعلمن.
And the women know that their husbands are.
سأل من بأمامك الآن.
And ask the people who are in front of you and around you.
صحيح أم لا؟
Is this true or not?
النساء يعلمن أن أزواجهن يفسنين.
That the women know that their husbands are committing zina?
صحيح?
Yes.
And I know this. I know this.
قد اشتكي لي كم من النساء بهذا الأمر.
How many women have complained of this matter before?
المهم قلت له هذا العدد وهذا الفساد تريد أن تبقى حالها كذا كل رجل
يدري. So
العدد هائل.
The ratio is what it is. And the men's tendencies and their nature are being fulfilled one way or another. And you see them in such corruption and manifested in adultery all around the clock.
مع أن كثير من الرجال لا يصلحون للزوجية ما عندهم مسؤولية.
While most of men are not even fit to marry one woman, they're not even
ما صالح للزواج أصلاً.
They're not even fit to be married.
فهذا قليل والقليل من هو الصالح للزواج.
So then they're the minority already.
كثير مكتفي بالزنا والفساد.
And then the minority of the minority now are taking care of their needs in accordance with fornication and corruption.
فمن هذا القليل إذا لم يتزوج أربعة أو ثلاثة ماذا سيقع للمسلمات الطيبات ماذا سيقع؟
So then if this few who are qualified amongst the men are not marrying more than one in many of these
ماذا سيقع للنساء؟
then what is going to happen to what's going to happen to men, what's going to happen to women? What are they're going to just be satisfied and content with just crying at home and or entering into fornication and adultery? Is there another option that I don't know about? So he said, okay, that makes sense. So he said, you teach from behind a barrier, a partition. Why? I said, that's great. You have a sisters or a daughter or mother. You want to put them in front of men and allow every guy to look at them and comment, and this whole world to be seeing them
and
getting to know them very easily. Any type of whatever, and to, for them to, you know, fall for all of these men and to be. Are you denying the attraction of men towards women and women towards men? So I told him, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us this. That would a person like for somebody to have zina with their mother or with their aunt or with their sister or their daughter? Any man who has any ghayrah, would he be satisfied with this happening to him? Or a mother, or with his mother. Are you a man or are you ambiguous?
نعم ambiguous. نعم أنت خذها. فقال نعم هذا صحيح.
So he said, okay, yeah, I understand. فمد يده
وقال أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.
And then he put his hand forward and he said the head's shahada.
سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. ثم ضيع المسلمين ما عنده نوع من الذل والهوان والتواضع في غير محله ما رأيت قوما مثلهم.
The Muslims, unfortunately,
have such
a level of degradation and humiliation and lowliness and feeling of insecurity and inferiority complex compared to other than them that I have not seen in any other population. And they think that this is an honor for them once they display this degradation, and that you see the humiliation that they have towards other than themselves, that once you see that their respect for non-Muslims and how they value their opinion more, and especially if they were white, then they would be. Then, wow, that is the greatest accomplishment for them. To them, their acceptance
would
be. And that's the pinnacle of acceptance that they view, that I'm going to be interviewed alongside a white person who accepts my opinion as valid. Especially if he has degrees from a university. That is the greatest. As if this is their Jannah. That is what
they are. Saudi
That I am an African or Mauritanian or Saudi, and I am seen on the same level as this European, then I
that is
the great success. And all the Mauritanians, they would be saying the statement of the hypocrites, that I wish I was with them so that I could succeed like they did. That they would be watching them in the African countries, and they would be saying that, oh, look at this, that guy, he's with a white guy, with a white Christian. Look, not only is he white, mashallah, he's also a Christian that is accepting him. that look at this person, mashallah. And alhamdulillah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved me from and what is in my people. What the evil people. Did these people have such an inferiority complex that they respect the West in such a manner that is unbelievable?
سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين سبحانك لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك نسألك اللطف والإعانة في جميع الأحوال وحال حلولنا في رموسنا ونسألك اللطف والإعانة في جميع الأحوال وحال حلولنا في رموسنا نسألك اللطف والإعانة في جميع الأحوال وحال حلولنا في رموسنا اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ومشايخنا اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ومشايخنا اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ومشايخنا رب اغفر لي ولأمي رب اغفر لي ولأمي رب اغفر لي ولأمي رب اغفر لي ولأبي رب اغفر لي ولأبي رب اغفر لي ولوالدي رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعائي ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعائي ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعائي ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعائي ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا الا غفرته ولا هما الا فرجته ولا ضالا الا هديته ولا مريضا الا شفيته ولا جاهلا الا علمته ولا زائغا الا قومته ولا مظلوما الا نصرته ولا فقيرا الا اغنيته ولا حاجه من حوائج الدنيا والاخره لك فيها رضا ولنا بها صلاح الا قضيتها اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معاصيك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوانا ما أحييتنا واجعل وارثا منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادنا وانصرنا على من عادنا وانصرنا على من عادنا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا اللهم يا ربي بجاه نبيك المصطفى ورسولك المرتضى طهر قلوبنا من كل وصف يباعدنا عن مشاهدتك ومحبتك وأمتنا على السنة والجماعة والشوق إلى لقائك يا رب العالمين اللهم رب الحل والحرام ورب المشعر الحرام ورب البيت الحرام يا ربي بجاه نبيك محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام وبجاه بيتك الحرام وبجاه المشعر الحرام وبكل عبد لك يا أرحم الراحمين خصصته بالإنعام أسألك يا أرحم الراحمين ألا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة لك رضا ولنا في صلاح إلا قضيتها يا ربنا بحق أسمائك العليا وصفاتك العليا وبحق ذاتك يا رب العالمين وبحق نبيك وبحق حرمك وبحق من له جاه عندك نسألك يا أرحم الراحمين أن تزرع الخير في قلوبنا وأن تعطينا من الخير ما لا يعلم علمه إلا أنت وتصرف عنا من السوء ما لا يعلم علمه إلا أنت اللهم إنا نسألك أن تهب لنا من الخير ما لا يعلم علمه إلا أنت وتصرف عنا من السوء ما لا يعلم علمه إلا أنت اللهم إنا نسألك حبك وحب نبيك وحب العمل الذي يقرب إليك اللهم إنا نسألك فعل الخيرات وترك المنكرات وحب المساكين اللهم إنا نسألك فعل الخيرات وترك المنكرات وحب المساكين اللهم إنا نسألك فعل الخيرات وترك المنكرات وحب المساكين وإذا أردت فتنة من الناس فاقبضنا إليك غير مفتونين اللهم إنا نسألك فعل الخيرات وترك المنكرات وحب المساكين وحب المساكين وحب المساكين وإذا أردت فتنة من الناس فاقبضنا إليك غير مفتونين اللهم لا تجعل في قلوبنا حب الأغنياء والكافرين اللهم أزل من قلوبنا حب الأغنياء اللهم يا أرحم الراحمين ربط قلوبنا على حب نبيك وأصحاب نبيك وآل نبيك صلى الله عليه وسلم ومساكين المسلمين يا رب العالمين وحل بيننا وبين تعظيم الكافرين والأغنياء يا رب العالمين اللهم لا تدع في قلوبنا تعظيما لأحد على غناه يا رب العالمين اللهم لا تدع في قلوبنا تعظيما لأحد على غناه ولا على منزلته الدنيا يا رب العالمين اللهم اجعلنا من المتحابين فيك والمتواصلين فيك والقائمين بحقوقك يا أرحم الراحمين من الذين يظلهم الله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله يا أرحم الراحمين من الذين تحابوا فيك وافترقوا عليك واجتمعوا فيك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم إنا نسألك لنا ولوالدنا ومشايخنا وأحبابنا وطلابنا وأزواجنا وذرياتنا ومن أوصانا ومن استوصانا وعامة المحسنين إلينا كل خير في الدنيا والآخرة أن لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا ضالا إلا هديته ولا مخذولا إلا نصرته ولا مظلوما إلا نصرته يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا ومن المعاصي ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوانا ما أحييتنا اللهم ألف على الخير بين قلوبنا اللهم ألف على الخير بين قلوبنا وأصلح ذات بيننا واهدنا سبل السلام ونجنا من الظلمات إلى النور وجنبنا الفواحش والفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن اللهم ألف على الخير بين قلوبنا وأصلح ذات بيننا واهدنا 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 سبل السلام ونجنا من الظلمات إلى النور وجنبنا الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن يا من لا تراه العيون ولا تخالطه الظنون ولا يصفه الواصفون ولا تغجره الحوادث ولا يخشى الدوائر يعلم مثاقل الجبال ومكائل البحار وعدد قطر الأمطار وعدد ورق الأشجار وعدد ما أظلم عليه الليل وأشرق عليه النهار لا تواري منه سماء سماء ولا أرض أرض ولا بحر ما في قعره ولا جبل ما في وعره اجعل خير أعمالنا أواخرها وخير أعمالنا خواتمها وخير أيامنا أيام نلقاك بها يا أرحم الراحمين خير أيامنا أيام نلقاك بها يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم أصلح أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم اللهم فرج عن أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم اللهم ارحم أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم اللهم استر أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم اللهم اغفر لأمة محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم اللهم استر أمة محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم اللهم اصلح أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم فرج عن أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم اللهم ارحم أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم اللهم اغفر لأمة محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم اللهم استر أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم اللهم اصلح أمة محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم اللهم فرج عن أمة محمد صلى الله تعالى وسلم اللهم ارحم أمة محمد صلى الله تعالى وسلم اللهم اغفر لأمة محمد صلى الله تعالى وسلم اللهم استر أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم استرنا بستك الجميع اللهم استرنا بستك الجميع اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية والمعافاة الدائمة في الدين والدنيا وفي الآخرة اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد صلاة تنجينا بها من جميع الأهوال والآفات وتقضي لنا بها جميع الحاجات وتطهرنا بها من جميع السيئات وترفعنا بها عندك على الدرجات وتبلغنا بها أقصى الغايات من جميع الخيرات في الحياة وبعد الممات إنك على كل شيء قدير اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم في كل لمحة ونفس في كل علم لك اللهم صل صلاة تامة وسلم سلاما تاما على نبي تفرج به الكرب وتزال به الهموم وتدرك به الرغائب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الأمل وسلم عليه وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس في عدد كل معلوم لك اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وذريته وآل بيته كما صليت على إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم صل على محمد وأزواجه وذريته كما صليت على إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وأزواجه وذريته كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه صلاة وسلام وبركة لا يحصى عددها ولا ينقطع مددها اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد السابق إلى الخلق نوره ورحمة للعالمين ظهوره اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد السابق إلى الخلق نوره ورحمة للعالمين ظهوره اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد السابق إلى الخلق نوره ورحمة للعالمين ظهوره اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد السابق إلى الخلق نوره ورحمة للعالمين ظهوره اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأمته أفضل الأمم وعلينا معهم أجمعين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحاب سيدنا محمد وأمة سيدنا محمد وعلينا معهم أجمعين يا أرحم الراحمين. واجعلنا بالصلاة عليهم من المرحومين. واجعلنا بالصلاة على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وآله وصحبه من المرحومين. اللهم اجعلنا بالصلاة عليهم من المرحومين. اللهم اشرح بالصلاة على صدورنا ويسر بها أمورنا واغفر بها ذنوبنا واستر بها عيوبنا وحقق بها آمالنا وارزقنا بها ما نؤمل يا رب العالمين. اللهم مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم اجعلنا من غرباء هذا الزمان الأقلين. اللهم اجعلنا من الأقلين غرباء هذا الزمان يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا ممن قال فيهم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بدأ الإسلام غريبا وسيعود غريبا فطوبى للغرباء. اللهم اجعلنا من الحاصلين على طوبى يا أرحم الراحمين في هذا الزمان. اللهم اجعلنا من الأقلين. اللهم اجعلنا من الأقلين. اللهم اجعلنا من الأقلين. اللهم اجعلنا من غرباء هذا الزمان. يا ربي ثبتنا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة. اللهم يا ربي بجاه أسمائك الحسنى وصفاتك العلى نسألك الثبات في هذه الأيام الخطيرة. يا ربنا بحق الأسماء. يا ربنا بحق الأسماء أعزنا في الأرض والسماء. يا ربنا بحق الأسماء أعزنا في الأرض والسماء. يا ربنا بحق الأسماء أعزنا في الأرض والسماء. وعل قدرنا الدني بقدرها عندك واسقنا رحيق سرها. وعافنا بها من البلاء وأولنا الشكر على الآلاء. والنصر عاجلا على الأعداء أنت المجيب فأجب دعائي. والنصر عاجلا على الأعداء. والنصر عاجلا على الأعداء أنت المجيب فأجب دعائي. وهب لنا بها لدى المنية خاتمة حسنى هي الأمنية. بأطي طيبة المرضية صلى علي خالق البرية. وصلي معك السلام أبدا على شفيع الكائنات أحمد. وهب لنا بها لدى المنية خاتمة حسنى هي الأمنية. بأرض طيبة المرضية صلى علي خالق البرية. فصلي يا ربي مع السلام على حبيبي سيد الأنام. وهب لنا بها لدى المنية خاتمة حسنى هي الأمنية. بأرض طيبة المرضية صلى علي خالق البرية. صلي معك السلام أبدا على شفيع الكائنات أحمد. اللهم يا ربي بجاه نبيك وأسمائه الحسنى وآله الأكرمين وصحابته المقربين. أسألك يا أرحم الراحمين أن تعطينا ما نريد وفق ما نريد. يا ربي بالنبي وأسماء النبي حقق مرادنا وعجل مطلبي. يا ربي بالنبي وأصحاب النبي حقق مرادنا وعجل مطلبي. يا ربي بالنبي وآل ذا النبي حقق مرادنا وعجل مطلبي. يا ربي بالنبي وأمة النبي حقق مرادنا وعجل مطلبي. وعافني ونجني ومن معي في المؤمنين من ألم ووجعي. واختم لدى الممات يا رباه لنا بلا إله إلا الله. محمد أرسله الإله وما لنا من ملجأ إلا هو. واختم لدى الممات يا رباه لنا بلا إله إلا الله. محمد أرسله الإله فما لنا من ملجأ إلا هو. واختم لدى الممات يا رباه لنا بلا إله إلا الله. محمد أرسله الإله فما لنا من ملجأ إلا هو. ويسر لنا سبيلا سبيلا لحج بيتك الحرام كيما نزور المصطفى أصل الهدى عين الهدى نور الهدى محمد. كيما نزور المصطفى أصل الهدى عين الهدى نور الهدى محمد. كيما نزور المصطفى أصل الهدى عين الهدى نور الهدى محمد. صلى عليه الله ما هب الصبا صلى عليه الله ما بدر بدا وآله وصحبه أهل الهدى. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. الحمد لله الذي بنعمته وجلاله تتم الصالحات. الحمد لله رب العالمين الذي بنعمته وجلاله تتم الصالحات. الحمد لله حمدا يوافي نعمه ويكافئ مزيده. الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. لقد جاءت رسل ربنا الحق. اللهم صل وسلم على محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم في نعمة رسول الله سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك سبحان ربك رب العزه عما يصفون يا ربي لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك.